So now I'm very delighted to introduce our last guest speaker today, Mr. Victor Wang, co-founder of Zhen Fund and co-founder of New Oriental Education and Technology Group.
Mr. Wang is also Zhen Fund's Director of Entrepreneurial Thoughts and frequently advises portfolio companies on their mission and vision. He is also a well-known humanities and philosophy scholar.
Prior to Zhen Fund, he was the co-founder of New Oriental Education and Technology Group, the largest provider of private education in China.
So we are honored to have you here today, Mr. Wang. Welcome.
Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hi, Li Feng. Nice to see you. Yeah, we used to be colleagues at New Oriental. Yeah. So it's easy to use. Just press this arrow button. Okay. This one? It works? Okay, thank you very much for your time. I think probably it's better sitting here than going outside. It's very cold. You have no other choice. So in life, sometimes we have no other choice. It's the best timing for people like us, right? Because that's a very convenient way for us to hold you together and spend some time together. Hopefully, this gathering will not waste your time. Now, in my talk, I was told that I can choose using any language, but only this afternoon they told me that the only language that I have to use is English. So thank God I know English, right? And all of a sudden I changed my PPT into an English. Today I'd like to share with you something about what we're doing at Zhen Fund. As you know that Zhen Fund was a seed stage fund focusing only on the very early stage of startups. We don't put on our energy on any later stage, but only focused on the very, very early stage. How early? As early as the startup people, they don't even know what they're going to do. So at Zhen Fund, my colleague, friend, and 33-year colleague, Bob Xu, Xu Lao Shi, had a famous saying. He said, at Zhen Fund, we don't trust BP because anybody can polish a BP, especially MIT students, a Harvard student. It's no difficult job for you. You can have a very shining BP for the early stage people. You know, BP doesn't mean anything. And we don't have numbers to trust because you haven't started to do anything. Where do you get the numbers? Then what we do? At Zhen Fund, we have a philosophy. We only trust people. Probably we have no other choice because we don't trust number, we don't have number, we don't trust BP, we don't even study trend, sector, because at early stage, trend doesn't mean anything. When you start doing something, all of a sudden you see trend like wind blowing in another direction. Okay, business model can always change. Because the word model means you build something, you can always modify it, you can always change it, and model, you know, doesn't mean anything for the early stage people. So at Zhen Fund, we gradually have this philosophy of looking at specific qualities in people, then what we're going to look for when coming to making investment. At Zhen Fund, okay, we have two things at Zhen Fund that all the investors has to buy in. First of all, Zhen Fund is a fund we think is a money with values. Going back to 5 years ago, after leaving New Oriental, like Li Feng, right? Li Feng left earlier, right? That's why you have more money to manage now. We should have left earlier, right? Now Li Feng has more money than Lao Yu now, maybe. So congratulations. Going back to 5 years ago, after sort of retired from New Oriental, from the daily executive positions, Bob and I were sort of lost in life. Because after you having enough money to cover your daily expenses, you know, all of a sudden you can manage your, you know, a good lifestyle. And all of a sudden you start thinking about, you know, what's the meaning of money? Okay, you want to add more zero to your account. It doesn't make you happier, okay? Probably will make somebody else happier. But to us, you know, we just need three meals. We need one bed. Oh, no, he has one bed. I have one bed. Each of us only needs one bed, one wife, right? One dream. But what other things you can expect from life? So then Bob talked to me. He said, Victor, we shouldn't just retire with our money become, just enjoy life. We should still look for some other meanings. The meaning as significant, as influential, you know, like what we do through New Oriental, right? So around that time, Bob said, let's use some of money that we make from New Oriental, because so the students give us money to give the school, go to New York Exchange, then both Li Feng and I, you know, got some money, right? We should use some money to really support the young startup people when they need it, okay? We are not professional or trained in terms of making investment, because Bob was coming from a background of music, right? He's a musician, actually. And I studied English literature. You know, I'm more familiar with Shakespeare than VC and PE. But later I realized that, okay, Shakespeare was the very earliest person who thinking of what's the trend to invest. Because he has a very famous saying, to be or not to be. That is a question, right? Now everybody talking about to be business investment is a very, very strong trend, at least now in China, okay? So after thinking of that, Bob and I decided to put our money together and start doing a fund that has an ultimate goal to help the young Chinese people in the very beginning, especially the people who studied overseas and they have some ideas and they have some dreams and they want to, you know, make them dreams come true through doing startups. So after that, we started a Zhen Fund. So Zhen Fund actually started with Neil Shenanpeng at the very beginning. Because before doing this fund, I asked Bob the question. I said, both of us coming from a non-investment, you know, profession, how can we make our fund successful and attract, you know, fund and attract good deals so that we can make it a sustainable business? And he said, what do we need if we want to make this come true? I said, we have to bring someone who is so experienced in terms of investment worldwide and bring in the expertise that we can learn from so that we can together make this fund a very good fund. Okay, because by that time, when Bob asked me, said, let's do a fund, the first question I threw back to him was, I said, Bob, do we need another fund? Because in the world, so many funds, why we need another fund? He said, no, because this fund is going to be unique, will be different from all the other funds in that it should be a fund with values. Okay, values, 价值观. The money with values, and not just value, okay? Because we believe that values is a soil that value can really grow out of. Okay, well, what are values? Values are useless in the first place, but it's so important, so fundamental, so essential in life, like love, courage, right? Tolerance, like Donald Trump, right? If you have no values, how can he go up? right? So value sometimes is more important than the value itself. So Bob, in his mind, he said, well, Zhen Fund should be a fund or money with values. What are values? Because by the time we thought, if we really can help produce another generation of Chinese entrepreneurs who can really make a dialogue, open dialogue with the world, what are the qualifications they should have? What are the characteristics they should have? You know, absolutely one thing we totally believe that they should have integrity, because a lot of people think that the Chinese, you know, business people, they don't have integrity. They just copy from U.S. and make money in China and sell it to U.S. Well, probably in the past, it was like that. But right now, it's no more true, right? Probably partially because of Zhen Fund, right? Okay. And Bob has another vision. He said, why we need to have another fund given so many other funds around available? He said, one day, when we leave the legacy, Zhen Fund should be the largest small fund in the world. I said, that's good, okay? As an angel fund, given this fund size, we can never expect to make it uncontrollable big, right? That's our principle. But largest means we should have the right values, we should have the correct vision, we should have the quick judgment, we should have the trust and love really for the entrepreneurs. So grow together with them, share their dreams so that even financially we can expect more return simply because we're doing something that is not financially related things. So after doing this, I think, yes, I join you. Then let's do it together. So we convinced Neil and Sequoia China becomes, you know, our GP for the first fund. Then Zhen Fund started in 2011. That was when we were have a discussion. They said we are making a secret discussion, and Neil was still at a loss, didn't know what we're talking about, right? But later he agreed. So just to make a long story short, since our inception, Zhen Fund has come to its fifth year. Now we started with a fund size $30 million. Now after fourth fund, accumulatedly, Zhen Fund has $500 million under management. Feng has 3.6 billion, right? RMB. Oh, good, RMB. Oh, then if we times six, almost the same. Good. Because by that time I was so depressed. I said, wow, we're working so hard, and how come Feng has so much money? Well, so the sign, sometimes the sign makes a difference, right? I'm sorry. That's very good. And for the past 5 years, we have invested in 400 plus deals. And everybody talking about this year, it's a winter for investment or entrepreneurship, entrepreneurs, startups. And we don't think so, because just for this year, we have so far invested in 100 plus deals. And a lot of people think, why? Because you're crazy. You don't know. You don't want to make sure that the qualities that you make invested in. We totally, don't think so. Because right now in China, what happens to the startup landscape is more and more mature people leaving big companies. More and more people are coming from big companies started to do the startups compared with 3 or 4 years ago. Maybe only college graduates, they wanted to do startups. But now, more experienced entrepreneurs, they want to do that. So given the quality of the people and the quality of the things they are going to do, we totally believe that we shouldn't stop or slow down the pace of our investment. So winter for us, it means spring, right? like Shelley, the poet Shelley said, if winter has come, how can spring be far away? Yeah, that's what we totally believe. Even talking about bubbles, whatever. I love bubbles. When you take a bath, you have to use soap. Why? It has bubbles. Why you have bubbles? Because after washing away all the bubbles on your body, you have a cleaner body, right? The bubble is also fundamental, both for investment and for those startup people, okay? If you have no bubbles, you have less choice, and it doesn't mean that when you have less choice, you have more quality company will come out. The unicorns coming out of the ocean of bubbles, right? A lot of people died on the way to success, but only, you know, in the atmosphere of so many people trying to achieve things, those, you know, companies were greatly encouraged, and gradually they become unicorns. Okay, if you cannot just say one company, one unicorn, then that's the world. No, it never is like that. So, talking about our, you know, performance of investment. Within those 400-plus portfolio companies, so far we have several listed and also several unicorns in terms of U.S. dollars, right? Like this, okay. The Jiaogang platform is the largest platform exchanging steels, right? And Yidao is sort of a Uber thing, even though, you know, Didi is a bigger name, but Yidao was actually acquired by Le Shi at $1.2 billion. And 51Talk, he was online one-to-one English learning platform that was listed 3 months ago at New York Exchange. And like a dating company that like American Match.com was listed several years ago. And right now there's a called Meicai. Meicai, this one is just a platform that services all the small restaurants across the country. So that it solves a lot of problems for the small restaurant owners. And unicorns to be, that is talking about US dollar 200 million valuation above, we have, you know, those candidates, like a Poppy, yeah. Poppy, yes, last week, it was first time for me to see her in person. The night before, I didn't sleep. It was not because I was so excited, because I was having a jet lag. But it was the first time for me to see her. You know, Poppy was a sort of interesting case, because she provides the content in a funny way, commenting about their daily life in China. He had almost 20 million viewers of her videos. And several months ago, there's a audition, a bidding for her advertisement that raked, I think, 22 million RMB for that advertisement slot. And we have WeWork, like WeWork in US, like Ofo, the campus bicycle sharing, you know, platform, and like Hyperloop. Hyperloop was a very interesting case, because in the US, a lot of mainstream funds, they never believe that Hyperloop will come true. This idea comes from Elon Musk's third crazy idea. He had his Tesla, he had his SpaceX. Now the last one, he wanted to change human transportation in this Hyperloop. But he opened this conception to the world, like MIT probably also tried to do Hyperloop. But the company Hyperloop One, we invested, happens to be probably the first company that can materialize this conception. Because in 3 years, the first real commercial high-speed railway will be in use in Dubai. So that's the companies, and some baby unicorns, like this one. Okay, now I'll say something about the Unique Nitrogen Fund, what we can do for those young entrepreneurs, why you should come to us, and what we look for when we make investment in you. Okay, first of all, we are entrepreneur friendly. All the funds will say this, but I believe that we are really, really friendly, okay? At least as friendly as a phone's freeze, right? Okay. Why? I just give you some examples. By being entrepreneur friendly, you should really, really put your, 3 minutes? Okay, I have 3 points to make, yeah. Entrepreneur friendly, okay. We just revolutionized a lot of routine practice in this sector of investment. For example, we just make a TS term sheet less than one page using human understandable language, not just lawyer understandable one. And we also shortened SPA, which is usually 20 to 40 pages, to less than 2 page, or also human, average, human friendly language, okay? Things like that. Both Bob and I, using our 20 years of doing a business to really, really think in entrepreneur's way. If we were them, what we would do, okay? So we just did that. And the second point is that we are really, really global, has a global vision. A lot of people think that Gen Fund only invested in students studying overseas. Yeah, partially it was true because of our New Oriental prehistory, right? We have a natural abounding and connection with the students all over the world. But we don't just invest in them. We also invest some, international startups like U.S.-based, run by Americans and people from India, from England, from Germany, everywhere from the world. We're trying to bridge the gap of capital and culture between China and the world. I just give you some example, Hyperloop, like a present one, just recently acquired by another U.S. company. It's U.S.-based and run by U.S. people, recently acquired at the check size, 100 million U.S. this year. And like Histowitz, it's a cloud-based database and a virtual microscope for tumor specimens. And the founder, the lady, Chen Keyi, was the first Chinese female founder to be accepted into YC. So a year and a half ago, when I first met her, I decided to invest in her. We tried to get some opinion from the mainstream funds focusing on medical investment. None of them think she was worth being invested in. But now, after YC, training and a lot of mainstream comes to contact her, think that her idea is pretty good. And the third one, the last point, is that we have a lot of key resources that we really, really provide for the people that we invested in. We have a multi-dimensional service package that really safeguards and accelerates the growth of our portfolio companies. So we grow with them like this, lifeline support, like marketing, fundraising, talent acquisition, and legal and finance. And we have very special event like Gen Talk. We invited all the top entrepreneurs in China to share with our CEOs of the companies that we have invested in about the strategy, the philosophy, how to build their brand of the companies like this, all the very important issues. Gen Fund Demo Day is held semi-annually, and it has become a very important day for almost all the major VCs in China. So this is a very good platform and time for startup people to meet those in potential investors. And we have a very special a program that is targeted especially for overseas studying students like you. So if you have any ideas, even very vague ideas, that is, if you think your life curve will not go to the career path that is designed, controlled, made by other people for you, you want to really try to create your curve of life and try to go another path that is a startup path, then you probably should think of this program. Because at Zhen Residence, what it do is that it uses a two-week time to give you a lot of like a business school programs. But when people ask me what's the difference between this business school and Zhen Fund mini business school, I said all the business schools study the dead cases. We are just to study the case that is going on. That's live cases. So you will be part of the case creator. Participant instead of just the cold outsider to just study. So if you are interested in this program, you can try to apply this. And when you are accepted, and you will spend 2 weeks in China, mostly in Beijing, and I will personally take you to visit during the 2 week period about 20 or more, very good, we thought, very good companies that are in different sectors. So you can have a real intimate, immediate contact with the founders of those companies, try to understand what are their dreams. When they try to realize their dream, what are the obstacles they have encountered and how they can use their solutions to tackle these problems. So I think this is a good program for you, and I really hope that through this, you immediately touch the China startup ecosystem, or you can immediately see the China startup landscape. Even though a lot of people think, wow, in Beijing, every several days, you have a heavy smog. You cannot see anything. Well, that's the best timing for China startups. Because when God closed one door, he has to close another and another. But it will open the largest door to a new vision. Because with eyes, we have to see things. If we cannot see reality, we can only see the future. So that's the best timing for China. Come back. Thank you.
Thank you.